This is Praise Channel TV. You are welcome.
What to do when you don't know what to do? Shortly on Praise Channel TV, after this time of prayer. Daddy, I give you praise one more time for this opportunity to come upon this platform, O Lord, to share with your people. On this platform, you are giving us on a daily basis words of hope, encouragement, and salvation. Lord, I make myself available in your hands for you to use me as a vessel unto honor. Holy Spirit, breathe upon me the fresh grace and unction and anointing that will help me to function in my capacity and calling as your servant. Lord, use me more than ever before, and let all the glory be yours forever. Thank you, Almighty God. This program and channel and telecast is dedicated unto you afresh today. In Jesus' mighty name I prayed. Amen and amen. What to do when you don't know what to do? My pleasure to welcome you one more time to this channel. My name is Evangelist Chuks Chidubeke, Praise Channel, This Kind God, I'm a minister of the gospel. I'm so glad to have you visit with us one more time today. Please, if you have not subscribed to this channel, I plead with you to encourage us, help us to do more by clicking on that red subscribe button there, then click on the bell sign and click on the like button to like the channel and leave a comment with us in the comment section. Thank you very much. You are free to go through any of the social media handles displayed there and reach me, and all the glory belongs to Jesus. Hallelujah. Let's go on with what we have today. What to do when you don't know what to do? It's a serious matter. It's a serious topic. We are in a very perilous time. The Bible says that perilous times shall come. In our generation now, it has come. It has come. All over. Nigeria, Africa, Europe, America, Canada, Australia. All over. Perilous times. But there is what to do. Let's go through what the Bible has for us today. Our scripture is taken. We have three quick scriptures to read. Number one is Matthew chapter 11, verse 28. Matthew 11:28. Here the Bible says, Jesus inviting us, he says, "Come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest." Jesus is inviting you. He's saying, in the midst of all the challenges, tribulation, hardship, stress, pressures, especially in my continent, in my country, Nigeria, Africa, people are going through terrific, terrible times. Hardships, lack, wants, bills unpaid. Yes, the COVID-19 lockdown has been eased up reasonably in our country, Nigeria, in Africa, various places. But people are still finding it very difficult to feed. People are going through all manner of terrific times, because the bills are mounting, but the income is not mounting. But there is a way out. In the midst of the fears and challenges, there's a way out. Jesus is inviting you and I to come unto him with all the labor and the heavy laden that we have been laded upon, that has been placed upon us in our generation. There's a way out. The solution is in Jesus. One more time today, I'm presenting a solution to you. The ultimate solution is Jesus. He's inviting you to come unto him with your load and luggages and baggages. He said, "I will give you rest." He will replace your loads and concerns and baggages and tribulation and sickness and disease and lack and every challenge in your life with his rest. He said, "I'll give you rest." The rest of the Lord is the ultimate, is the best. Look at the second scripture, Hebrews chapter 12, verse 2. Hebrews 12:2. Here the Bible says, "Looking unto Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith, who for the joy that was set before him endured the cross, despising the shame, and is set down at the right hand of the throne of God." Looking unto Jesus. You can't look unto the master and miss the way. Men will disappoint you. Women will disappoint you. Your family will disappoint you. Your leaders will disappoint you. Whatever, your friends, your colleagues, your neighbors, they will disappoint you. Your parents will disappoint you. Your children, they have the capacity to disappoint you. I'm sorry, even your pastor has the capacity to disappoint you, but they mean well, but they're human beings as well, never forget. But Jesus is the only one that cannot disappoint. Please come unto him. Look unto him. You can't look up to him and miss the way. You can't look up to him and not prosper. You can't look up to him and not be secured. You can't look up to him and not be protected and lifted and blessed. Look up to him. Salvation first, other things shall be added. Final scripture, John chapter 6, verses 5 and 6. John chapter 6, verses 5 and 6. Here, the Bible is telling you and I, when Jesus then lifted up his eyes and saw a great company come unto him, he said unto Philip, "When shall we buy bread that these may eat?" Look at what the Bible says there. Finally. "And this he said to prove him, for he himself knew what to do, what he would do. Jesus always knows what to do. Where can we get a solution? But he knew. He was just trying to see what Philip could do. The same way, today, you and I, our ultimate solution is Jesus. In fact, Jesus is the gospel. This is a Christian channel. Yes, we are reaching the world, even the world of everybody, unbelievers alike. But the ultimate here is Jesus. We lift him, we flaunt him, we promote him, we exalt him, because in him is life encapsulated, complete, perfected. Jesus himself is the way out. What do you do when you don't know what to do? Call upon Jesus. He said, call upon me in the time of trouble, and I will answer you. Come unto me, all you that labor and are heavy laden. I will give you rest. You need the rest of Jesus. You need the rest of God. You don't need to be in the company of those who are confused, who don't know what to do, all over the nation. I feel it so much when I see families that are confused, they are troubled, they are disturbed. First, some people don't even feed. In the other telecast, I encourage you to look out for friends and families and neighbors and people who you can spare something for. If you have two loaves of bread, spare one for someone else. If you have one loaf, you can even divide it. You may have a lot of food in your house. Some people trash food. They have more than enough and they are trashing food. Please look for a neighbor. It may be financial blessing. Maybe a little money, like 100 naira or even $10. You can be a blessing to somebody. Even $5. $1 can bless someone. Reach out to somebody. Maybe clothing, maybe shoes. Don't live alone. The world is waiting for the manifestation of the sons of God. You and I will reach the world and impact the world well when we empathize with them and feel with them and identify with them and reach out with them. Yes, with the gospel, but also with the good news and message of hope and encouragement. There is hope in the Lord. I passed your way today to encourage you, fellow Nigerians and Africans and beloved viewers. Don't give up. Don't give up. Jesus is there with you. Remember, he said that he's knocking at the door of your heart, that if you open, he will come in to do what? To sup with you, to abide with you, to bless you, to help you, to cleanse you, to save you, to deliver you from the challenges and troubles of this time. What to do when you don't know what to do is to call upon Jesus. He's inviting you himself. He said, come unto me with your load, with your baggages, with your luggages, and I will exchange that with my rest. That's what Jesus has promised us. And today, I want you to please open your mouth and begin to call upon Jesus. Whoever calls upon him shall be saved. That's what the Bible says. Can you call upon him now? In your situation, in your circumstance, in all that you're going through, call upon Jesus. Call upon Jesus right now. Call upon him to intervene in your own way, to intervene in your own way. I want to call upon him in tongues. The Bible says that we should build ourselves up in their most holy faith by praying always in tongues. I like to stir myself in tongues. I like to build myself up in tongues, to tune my spirit to what the Lord is saying. Allow me, so you'll be free. You can pray in any language. Gaboliya kasata. Elibuguzi intrapafule eba uzuri ekatanda moleda. Zekulu upale esendri kapatayaga. Nebru shadika badaluso ukapataya. I receive wisdom. I receive knowledge. I receive ideas on what to do to get by, to overcome this season. Patusi ikapa tipara, sound mind, knowledge, wisdom, grace, the anointing of God to flow, the presence of God. I receive all to God's glory. Receive yours, child of God. Mazule epatuzele, ringa madulu usapatele esisa kapataya. It is done in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. If you have not given your life to Jesus, this is the first and best place to start. So repeat after me if you want to give your life to Jesus. I plead with you, if you have not done it before, do it now. Say, Lord Jesus, please forgive me all my sins. I accept you as my Lord and Savior. Help me, Jesus, to serve you to the end. You are mine forever. I reject you, Satan, and your cohorts. I'm no longer yours. I decided to follow Jesus. Help me, Lord. In Jesus' name I have prayed. Amen. Now let me pray for you. Thank you, Lord, for this, your beloved, precious child has given his life to you. May you reign in this life as Lord forever. And Lord, I pray, help this one to serve you to the end. I cut off every plan of the forces of darkness against you, beloved child of God. Winning is your only option now. It will follow you always. The presence of God, goodness, mercy, they'll follow you always. Plus all the benefits of those who have given their lives to Jesus according to God's word. Plus lifting, promotion, salvation, healing, open heavens, breakthroughs, good marriage, good spouse, good husband, good wife, children, car, house, international connections, heavy finances. Receive all plus grace unto holiness. In Jesus' mighty name I prayed. Amen and amen. Thank you for your time again today. It is well with you. The Lord is your portion in the land of the living. Until we see during the next telecast, remain in the peace of the Lord. Remember, every Monday and Friday, by God's grace, between 5:30 a.m. and 6 a.m. Nigeria time, new contents are uploaded here. See you next time as we share. Subscribe to this channel and share this video and encourage someone. God bless you. Salute.